Hello everyone, so welcome to the second session of this problem, reversal linked list. So you can see here, in our first session we have solved this problem with the first approach, which was with the help of the pointer. So let us try to solve this problem with the help of recursion. So suppose we have four node, a linked list with four nodes, suppose having value 1, 2, 3 and 4. So with the help of recursion, we have to first reach the end, and if we reach the end and during the returning, if I apply a logic like suppose this node next should point to this node and this point node should point to this one and this one should point to this one and this one should point to none. If I have a logic like this while returning, then I have a node means our output will look like 4 is pointing to 3, 3 is pointing to 2 and 2 is pointing to 1 and 1 is pointing to none. So if I write a logic like this while returning, then we will get this our desired output, isn't it? So let us write the logic. So the very first logic we have to reach our base condition. Suppose this is our list, so the base condition will be we have to reach the end and we have to return from this. So if I write, suppose this is my reverse function which is initially having the head pointer, now if head dot next equal to none, I will return the head. This is my base condition. Suppose if I have only one node like this one and this is my head, and if I have head dot next equal to none, then I will simply return this. This is my base condition. Now else I have to call this reverse function with head dot next. Okay, the very first thing is to reverse this one. If I am standing at this 3, suppose I have a pointer, temporary pointer suppose p1, and if I am standing at this node and if I write a logic like p1 dot next dot next, p1 dot next is this 4 and dot next means this none equal to p1, it means this is pointing to 3, and if I write p1 dot next equal to none, so it will look like it is pointing to none, correct? This logic, if I write here instead of here, I'm writing here, suppose p1 dot instead of p1, let me write head. Suppose this is head, head dot next equal to head, and head dot next equal to none. So let us forget everything. Suppose I have only two node, for simplicity I have only two node, 1 and 2. Now currently this is head, now head dot next is none, not none, so I will call this reverse function with head dot next. So this will be my head. Now head dot next is none, yes, head dot next is none. So what I will do, I have to save this head. So for this I will save this in a p1. Now I have written here head dot next dot next while in a return. You can see here, if while reaching here this condition is failed, means I have reached the base condition, I am returning this head, means this 2 is returned. Now, suppose I'm giving number like 1, 2, 3 and 4. This is my reverse function. I am given a number like 1, 2, 3, 4 for these statements. So you can see here, at very first, I have a node having value 1. Okay, initially having value 1, and you can see here I have how many lines? 1, 2, 3, 4. I have lines 1, 2, 3, 4. Now my control will go in line first and it will check if head dot next equal to none. You can see here head dot next is not none, so it will go in line number 2, and then in line number 2 it is calling the same function with head dot next. So again it is calling with value head dot next, and here the value is 2, head dot next is 2. Now again I have 2, 3 and 4, these 4 statement in this reverse function. This is my reverse function. Now you can see here control will go in again in line number 1, head dot next equal to none. So you can see here head dot next is none, 2 is my head and head dot next is none, so it will simply return. So it is returning in line number 1 only, so it will return here to 2. So 2 is having value how, what, p1. So p1 equal to what, 2 for this line here. Now control will go in line number 3. I have written here head dot next equal to head. So head, currently my head is for this, my head is 1. Now head dot next equal to head. So this will point to 1. So line number 3 is done, and control is going in line number 4. In line number 4 I have written head dot next equal to none. Head dot next equal to none. So this is none, and if I write at last return p1, so p1 is having node value 2, so p1 will be returned. So you can see here 2 is pointing to 1 and 1 is pointing to none, and I have returned p1, and p1 is having the node 2. So this will be my head. So you can see here for 2 node, this is our desired output, means we have reversed the list. Now let us understand the same thing with the 4 node. Suppose I have value 10, 11, 12 and 13. So you can see here we have 4 lines. This is my reverse function. I have here 1, 2, 3 and 4. These lines 1, 2, 3, 4. So initially my head is here. Head is having value how much? 10. So 10 dot next equal to none. No. Line number 1 is executed. So head dot next is none. No. It will go in line number 2. In line number 2 I am again calling this same function with value head dot next. Head dot next is value, having value 11. So again I have this reverse function with 4 statements. This is the last one. This is 5. This is 5. Let me write here 5. Now you can see here when control goes in line number 1, again head dot next is none. No. So again in line number 2 it will call the same reverse function which have 5 statement, 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5, with value here 12. Again 12 dot next is not none, so again line number 2 will be executed, and again I have this reverse function with value 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 statement, and here value is 13. So now here you can see here 13, my head is 13, and 13 dot next means next is none. Yes, here it is none, line number 1. Here we have none is found, so it will simply return head. So it will simply return head. So control will go in line number 2 and it is returning 13. So I am saving that value in P1. So P1 is having value 13. Now you can see here. Now control is here in statement number 2. Now this is done. Now control will go in line number 3. So 3 I have written head dot next dot next equal to head. So my head is here. I am here currently at 12. Now head dot next is 13 dot next equal to head. So this 13 will be pointing to 12. And this is done. Line number 13 is 3 is done. Now line number 4 I have written head dot next equal to none. Head dot next equal to none. Line number 4 is done. And line number 5 I have written return P1. So return P1. So this will be returned to here. P1 is how much? 13. Now I am here on node number node with value 11. So line number 2 I am returned with value 13. Now control will go in line number 3, and 3 I have written head dot next. Now I am here, and head dot next dot next should point to head, and head dot next equal to none. Line number 3 and 4 are done. This head dot next equal to none is line number 4, and line number 5 I have written return P1. So P1 will be returned here, and P1 is having value 13. So I'm done with this line number 2. So in line number 3 I have written head dot next equal to head. So I am here, this is my head, and head dot next equal to head in line number 3. And line number 4 is head dot next equal to none. Head dot next equal to none. And line number 5 is return P1. So this will return to the original calling function, and P1 is 13. So it looks like 13 is pointing to 12, and 12 is pointing to 11, and 11 is pointing to 10, and 10 is pointing to none, and I'm returning P1. P1 is 13. So this logic works. So this is how recursion works during the return statement. So this is the simple 4 line of code. So let me write here. Let me delete this all. So here I have a base condition check if head dot next equal to none. If it is none, I will return simply return head. Otherwise I will call the reverse function with head dot next. And I will save that in P1. Now I will simply write the logic. This logic head dot next, head dot next dot next should point to head. This logic simple head dot next should point to head. And after pointing head dot next should become null. Next should equal to none. And at last we will simply return P1. So you can see here, what is this error? P1 is assigned but never used. Let me return P1. What is wrong here? Everything is correct. So let us run this code. So you can see here we are done with the hidden in simple test cases. Let us submit this code. So congratulations, we are done with the hidden test cases. So you can see here with the help of recursion we have solved this problem in a 4 line of code. So if you like this video, please do give thumbs up and subscribe to my channel, and thanks for watching. Thank you.